Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We had very critical lunar geometry on 26 August. I refer to that time since November last year because that kind of lunar geometry can result in great seismic activity easily around 8.5 magnitude. If we look at what actually happened, here on the SGI graph, magnitude 5.6 and larger, we see the high lunar peak indicating the critical lunar geometry with Mars and Neptune, and it was followed by a clustering of stronger seismic activity around the 28th, 2 days later, and it included a magnitude 7 earthquake deep below the Bali Sea. Obvious seismic response to the critical lunar geometry on 26 August. But so far, no great seismic activity, no magnitude 8 earthquake, and again, it has been more than 2 years now, so a big earthquake, a megathrust earthquake, could very well be around the corner. So what else happened later on the 1st of September, a magnitude 6.1 earthquake at the Kuril Islands, and that followed on the two lunar conjunctions with Mars and Neptune. Other than that, there was no stronger seismic activity, no magnitude 5.6 or larger earthquake. If you look at the next time frame up until the 12th of September, this is an overview, we see right at the beginning, that starts tomorrow, planetary conjunctions, critical planetary conjunctions indicated by the purple and red peaks. It indicates the involvement of Mercury and Venus. So let's have a look. Early tomorrow morning, we have Sun, Mercury, Saturn in a conjunction, and it will be followed later on the same day by Sun, Venus, Neptune. And that is a critical conjunction. This is a critical convergence, a near convergence. There are several hours in between those planetary conjunctions. What makes it even more critical is that it converges with critical lunar geometry, in particular Earth, Moon and Jupiter, also on the 4th, that is tomorrow in the afternoon. And then several hours later, Earth, Moon and Uranus as well. So we have two lunar conjunctions and both follow on two planetary conjunctions, and that all happens tomorrow. As a result, we could see an obvious seismic increase, a clustering of strong earthquakes, and it could include a mid to high 7 magnitude earthquake, approximately from the 5th to the 7th. And this is because on the 6th, we also have two planetary conjunctions, and they also involve Mercury and Venus, purple and red. We have Venus, Mercury and Mars, and that is early on the 6th. And almost at the same time, there are only a few hours, about 3-4 hours in between, Sun, Mercury and Earth. So in total, we have four planetary conjunctions from the 4th to the 6th. And we also have two lunar conjunctions also on the 4th. As a result, we could see an obvious seismic increase, again, a clustering, most likely from the 5th to the 7th. Could already be tomorrow on the 4th with the planetary and lunar conjunctions. And it could include a mid to high 7 magnitude earthquake easily. And in the worst case scenario, because we still haven't had that megathrust earthquake, that is also a possibility, especially because it is only a week, roughly, since the critical lunar geometry, the really critical lunar geometry with Mars and Neptune on 26 August. So be on watch in the next couple of days. On the 9th, we have Sun, Mercury, Neptune in a conjunction on itself, not really critical. But then on 10 and 11 September, we have a convergence of critical planetary geometry involving Mercury and Venus. These are the red and purple peaks. It starts on the 10th with dashed peaks. They indicate semi-right angles, and it is converging with a planetary conjunction Sun, Mercury, Venus, that is usually followed by a borderline low 6 magnitude earthquake, and that would probably be around the 12th. We also have additional lunar geometry. We have Earth, Moon, Venus following Sun, Mercury, Venus on the 11th and on the 12th. And we also have two right angles there with Earth, Moon, Jupiter and Earth, Moon, Uranus. And the time between those two right angles will be shorter if we go further into September. But they are not in an opposite fashion like with Mars and Neptune, so it will be less critical. But we will keep an eye on that, and I will refer to that geometry later on as well. And then also we have Earth-Moon-Neptune and Earth-Moon-Mars, right-angle lunar geometry on 7 and 8 September. If we look at the solar system, we see the planetary geometry with the red lines and also the lunar geometry with Jupiter and Uranus. This is from the 4th to the 6th. Again, that will be a critical time, and we really could see some big seismic activity as a result of that convergence of planetary and lunar geometry. It should not be underestimated. If we look at the atmospheric fluctuations, in the previous update I already mentioned the gap that we had from the 12th to the 24th, and it really continued on the 24th, it resumed on the 24th, and here we see fluctuations marking regions in the Indian Ocean, the Western Indian Ocean, and also to the north around the Arabian Plate, and this includes the region that was affected on 6 February with the major earthquakes in Turkey, central Turkey. On the 30th, we had some very interesting fluctuations, an obvious atmospheric peak marking regions around the western part of Africa, and it was shortly after followed by a moderate earthquake in Angola around 4.5 magnitude. Very interesting. More importantly, to the north we have a really dangerous zone that is off the coast of Portugal. And the last time that there was a big quake, a megafrost earthquake, was in 1755, close to magnitude 9 is the current estimate. It completely destroyed Lisbon at the time. More importantly, the Azores, Cape St. Vincent Ridge, between Portugal and the Azores, has been pretty active up until the end of the 1970s, with magnitude 7 and magnitude 8. That was from the 1930s to the 1970s, and then it stopped. It's now more than 45 years, and it's very well possible that major to great seismic activity will occur there in the short term. So that's also to keep something to keep in mind. And also to the north, south of Iceland, on the North Atlantic Ridge, there can be a 6 or even magnitude 7 seismic activity. And then finally, yesterday we had fluctuations, also obvious fluctuations, marking the regions near Tonga, Samoa, and to the north, again, the Kuril Islands. And we already had a magnitude 6 earthquake there 2 days ago. And the northeastern Pacific is a candidate for a big earthquake, well into the 8 magnitude range. It's been a while, and it's very well possible that that will happen somewhere between the Kuril Islands and Japan. We do not know for sure where the next big quake is going to occur, but the atmospheric fluctuations can be a significant indicator. Always check out the latest updates on the website, including the atmospheric fluctuations. Watch out in the next couple of days, because we have 4 planetary conjunctions on the 4th and on the 6th converging with 2 lunar conjunctions. We could see some really big seismic activity as a result, most likely from the 5th to the 7th, but a seismic increase may already start tomorrow, going into higher 5 magnitudes range. Stay safe, until next time.